This video was made possible by Squarespace. Build your beautiful website with Squarespace for 10% off at squarespace.com/HAI. If you grew up anytime in the last 49 years, you almost certainly can tell me how to get to Sesame Street. This show, first aired in 1969, is an icon in children's educational TV. Even more so than half as interesting, teaching kids about grammar, math, history, and even personal issues like divorce, tolerance, and death. The big boss of Sesame Street is Big Bird, as he's usually the one asking questions and learning lessons, both for his sake and the sake of the audience, which is why it's particularly troubling that Big Bird narrowly avoided total calamity, and I'm not talking about repeated attempts to gut PBS's funding. I'm talking about how Big Bird, along with the medium-sized human inside him, nearly died in a space shuttle. NASA's space shuttle program was designed to accomplish necessary routine orbital flights and was operational from 1981 to 2011 under the name Space Transportation System. It was particularly exciting for NASA because the shuttles were the only manned spacecraft that could be reused once returned to Earth. They wouldn't become orbital paperweights like the other rockets. At the same time, once the Apollo program wrapped up, interest in space exploration dwindled, so in an effort to increase interest, NASA started approaching people outside of NASA to go to space. NASA's overlord is, of course, Congress, so in an expensive way of asking them for more money, NASA sent then-Senator Jay Garn and then-Representative Bill Nelson into orbit. Having each served in the military, their credentials were not that different than non-politician astronauts, and being from Utah and Florida respectively, I assume they were only too happy to leave Earth for a while. After this proved somewhat successful, NASA wanted to open up the occasional orbital flight to other civilians and establish the Space Flight Participant Program. Big Bird's performer, Carol Spinney, was the first invited to orbit the Earth by the program in 1986. Though they didn't want Spinney to go as himself, they wanted him to go as Big Bird. This is because NASA wanted to focus on bringing civilians who were known as creative and educational, and wanted space travel to seem more approachable and interesting to the average Joe, so applicants to the program included hundreds of reporters like Walter Cronkite. Still, NASA sent the invitation to Carol Spinney as they wanted the shuttle program to seem exciting and fun to kids, and teach them that they too can go to space if they become an 8-foot anthropomorphic bird, I guess. Spinney may have been a perfect fit, but Big Bird was not. The Big Bird puppet is over 8 feet tall, and it turns out that they didn't plan to fly grotesquely oversized canary birds when designing the space shuttle. There'd be next to no room at all for Spinney, let alone the Big Bird puppet, so, much like Spinney, NASA's original talks to get the looming plumage of Big Bird into the shuttle didn't end up going anywhere, and NASA turned to a new initiative where they send teachers into space. In 1985, 114 applicants from the Teachers in Space project were sent to a conference in Washington, D.C. that lasted a week, where they would learn the ins and outs of space travel. From there, 10 teachers were chosen to undergo more training and interviewing before being narrowed down to one. The teacher who would replace Big Bird on the space shuttle was Krista McAuliffe, a social studies teacher from Concord, New Hampshire. If you recognize that name, then you know where this story is going. McAuliffe was chosen out of over 11,000 applicants to ride with the 6-member crew on the space shuttle Challenger. Tragically, on January 26, 1986, 73 seconds after liftoff, the Challenger exploded, killing everyone on board. This was due to an external tank explosion that was the end result of complications arising from the unusual coldness on the launch day. The Challenger explosion is regarded as one of the biggest tragedies of our time, and the Teachers in Space project ended immediately, though NASA did follow up on the project with the Educator Astronaut program, which required teachers to leave the classroom permanently to join NASA. If Big Bird had been on that space shuttle, which was at one point the plan, such a public death would have required Sesame Street to retire the character. The show is no stranger to hard-hitting themes, but still, the idea of Big Bird never coming back seems like something a bit too hard for a child audience to swallow. Thankfully, Big Bird's still around and living in his nest just behind 123 Sesame Street. If Big Bird was here right now, he'd probably say something like, "Half as interesting was brought to you today by the letters S, Q, U, A, R, E, S, B, A, C, E, and the number 10, because that's the percentage you'll get off by building your website at squarespace.com/HAI. A lot has changed since the era of trying to launch birds to space, including that the internet is now the definitive place where we go to find information on people, businesses, or really anything. Given that, it should be at the top of everyone's priority to have a great web presence presenting themselves or what they do, and Squarespace makes this easy with their customizable website builder, beautiful designer templates, and 24/7 award-winning customer support. They are the all-in-one solution for building a great website, and you can build your website for 10% off by going to squarespace.com/HAI, and you'll be supporting the show while you're at it.